y'all. How y'all doing today, man? This is Pod Talk Sports with your boy Matt D.
On a beautiful Wednesday, it's Kevo. We here.
Yes, sir.
What is it, 21st?
It's 21st.
And Tua is finally made it. He made it before Halloween. Yeah, he had a starting job before Halloween. Congratulations, Tua.
Hey, man, you can be a starting quarterback for Halloween, and you can pick Tua.
Yeah. Yeah, that's hard.
I'm starting QB in the NFL.
Tua jersey's gonna go up.
That is
true. Yeah, now that he finally up there.
Now, Tua Tagovailoa, Kevo, how do you feel about him, man?
I like Tua. Tua's good. But shit, anybody look good with all those weapons. You feel what I'm saying? So I'm looking at Mac Jones this year, and I want to say he's, for the first four games, I don't think nobody's thrown more than him in Alabama history.
Probably not.
Yeah,
he's 1,500 yards on the season.
Yeah, he's balling. So I'm looking like, damn, he doing this without Jerry Jeudy and without Henry Ruggs. Mac Jones might have went even crazier. So it's with the amount of weapons that Alabama had, bro.
Right.
I don't know if we didn't get to see Tua, you know, without that. He was so spoiled. That's my favorite word for Tua. Tua was spoiled in college. He had the best college football coach of all time. He had the weapons. He had the running back. He was spoiled. Even though he made them look good as they were.
He did.
They still helped him look as good as he was.
Right. That's, I would say, another advantage for him was being a lefty quarterback. It's like a lefty pitcher in baseball. It's just hard to go against. I mean, as a corner or a safety, you've been training all your life with probably a trainer that is a right-handed quarterback giving you those reads to look and move and make those movements. So playing against a left quarterback is like,
it's tough.
And
he looks better. That left-hand throw, like, that's why James Harden looks so fine.
Right.
Because he's left-handed. Like, left-handed players just look cool because we don't see this hand used often. Most people are dominary or right-hand users.
Right.
So, he's back, but he has a bye week. Smart. So you think Dolphins planned this out? Dolphins,
they,
like, you know what?
They planned it out, Kevo.
We're going to wait middle of the year. Bye week come. We're going to get them. But guess what? They didn't think this out. They're playing the Rams.
That wasn't smart. I'm going to tell
that's
you why.
Not their first. Yeah.
I seen Tua win some games, but when he goes against a passing defense, he looks frustrated.
Yeah.
He's a player that loves to extend plays.
Facts.
If you look at his highlight tape, there's 400 plays of him throwing the ball down the field and forcing it.
Yeah.
Now, that's a strength. He can force the play, but that's also on the weakness side.
Yeah.
You're forcing plays.
Yeah, it's easy to force when you got Henry Ruggs and Waddle.
Right.
They have broke the top of this defense. Let me just force it down the field. But when you have your best receiver is Devontae Parker, and I can't really name you too many other receivers on the Miami Dolphins roster. Good luck with that. Good luck.
And you're going against a defense that is – These are people
these
with
people,
four
bro.
Six kids. They got four or six children. They got real lives. This is their livelihood. They're not going to say, "Oh, I'm going to ease up on Tua
because
he's just a good kid."
Out.
They're going to destroy you.
The dude who gives Tua the most problems won't even be Aaron Donald or Jalen Ramsey.
Probably
one of the big
not.
Names. It's going to be a no-name guy who got to feed his 3-4 kids, and he's going to be on Tua ass the whole night. He's going to be like, "I was so focused on him. I forgot about this other pro
that want this signing
Jalen
bonus.
Ramsey might, you feel what I'm saying? Like, these dudes is hoopers
Come
for
on,
real,
man.
Bro. Like, it's a whole different ball game. So, Tua, I think they'll lose against the Rams. I do. I just don't think. And one thing I don't like, why they take Ryan Fitzpatrick out? It's just odd timing. Ryan Fitzpatrick was a hot quarterback. He was winning you games. He just blew out San Francisco, blew out the Jets. Who else did he upset? Shit, he almost beat New England week one. He's been playing good all year.
And then you got to think about it. With the teams like this right now, Kevo said something that's so key. He was like, the teams that are going to do well are the teams that can stay healthy.
Yeah.
You're putting a kid that's injury prone. He's had hip injuries, shoulder injuries, leg
injuries,
all type of injuries.
You don't even really, oh my God.
And you're putting him
earlier than needed. Why not? Why not let him just learn the offense a little more?
Why don't you let
his body heal a little more? Let him get more comfortable with the scout team. I know that's who he's playing with right now. There's no need to rush it right now, which I don't know what Miami's doing. But, hey, Miami's doing good. I like their coach, Brian Flores. He's doing his thing. So, let's hope he keeps it in a good direction.
Either Tua would do really well, or he's just going to look horrible. And I mean, you're not going to hear from other people to say it because they're going to hype him up. He looked good in college, it's and people praised him, so they're going to praise him until he falls.
Yeah.
So don't be surprised when you see this game and you see Tua look frustrated.
Yeah, look a little funny.
Because I've never seen him have to make no real check down throws ever in his college career. And for him to throw 4,000 yards a season and win a national championship his freshman year or whatever.
He threw to two first-rounders.
Yeah.
His whole thing, and now Devontae Smith and Jalen Waddle are the best receivers in college football. They're still there. Facts. That's who he was throwing to last year, too.
Facts.
So, he got to show me a little more. I like Tua, though. He's a good kid. Seems pretty humble. But he got to show me more. Let's see what he can do on the next level.
Hey, man. That's it, man. Hey, Tua, good luck, man. We hope you do well.
Good luck, bro.
Hey.
Take this bye week seriously.
That's it for us, man. Shout out to Pod Talk Sports. It's your boy, Matt D and Kevo, man. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe.
Always.